Is that India? What happened to her hair?
Well, if I want to shave it close, so I want to rock locks that'll take a bit away from the soul that I got. Little girl with the pressing curl. AJ, I got a Jerry curl. 13 and I got a...
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Angelic Beauty Products on YouTube. Thank you for tuning in. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share. What I'm going to be doing today is Miss Lauren's hair. I'm doing a Bantu Beach Wave. I'm sure you heard about that from Naptural85. So what I'm going to be doing on my model Lauren is a dry beach wave, which is where you twist the hair in a dry state and then you Bantu knot it. We're going to split this down the middle and we're going to make four big sections. And I'm not using a comb for this, I'm just parting it with my fingers. Good hair means curls and waves. Bad hair means you look like a slave. At the turn of the century, it's time for us to redefine who we be. Shut it off like a South African beauty. Now, each of these four parts, we have two in the back, two in the front. Each of these four parts, I'm gonna break down into four more parts. So at the end, we'll end up with 16. Okay, now I'm going to get started on the first part. I'm just going to take a quarter size amount of the oil in my hand and gently work it through her hair, making sure to get the ends and work it through to the root. And again, I'm not using a regular comb. I'm literally thumb combing it, finger combing it, whatever you want to call it, and working the product in as I go. And at the end, we'll see how much shedding she has. Now, doing just that, I just want to take a quick moment to show you her hair. How it looks just from doing that. Can you see that? If I stand behind it, if you could see the curls coming out just from literally putting some oil on it and thumb combing it. And I'm stretching her hair. And that's one of the reasons why you might want to do it in a dry state, because if you do your hair while it's dry, then it's already pretty stretched. So if you want to do the Bantu knots on dry hair, then you're keeping it stretched. So now I'm gonna install the twist, pulling it taut or tight toward the roots.
Is that India? What happened to her hair? Well, if I wanna shave it close, so I wanna rock locks that'll take a bit away from the soul that I got.
Once I get to the end, I'm going to spiral that around my finger. And if you wouldn't mind bending your head over just a bit. So I'm going to start Bantu knotting it and spiraling it in the same direction I made my twist. So I made my twist going back toward me. So I'm going to start twisting it and spiraling it around toward me. And I'm gonna keep on spiraling it around the base until all the hair is in there and there's no more strands left out. Boom. Can you turn so they can see that? So as you see, I didn't even need a bobby pin or anything to pin it down because I spiraled every single little strand in that spiral and kept tucking it as I was spiraling it on itself. On your head, it's what's underneath, and say, hey, I am not my head, I am not this skin, I am not your expectations, no, I am not my head, I am not this skin. Okay, so I just, we're about to start installing the last Bantu knot, so just put a nickel or quarter size amount of oil in your hand, warm it up, bend toward me, and I'm just going to take her hair and make sure I get the ends first and work my way up and start finger combing it through her hair so her hair, every bit of hair gets some oil on it. And I'm taking out any tangles as I go. And try and, when you thumb comb it, try and thumb comb it from different directions just so that you can make sure you're getting all the hair detangled as much as possible. And doing this with thumb and finger combing it, it also helps to stretch the hair even further. So now I'm just going to twist it up. Spiral it around my finger when I get to the end. And I'm going to start Bantu knotting it in the direction that I twisted it. Can you bend down just a little bit? So, as you can see, I twisted it going this way toward the back of her hair. So I'm going to start spiraling it that way. And what I'm doing is when I bring it around, I'm going to spiral it at the bottom of this little notch. So I'm spiraling it under itself. And I'm going to keep doing that until every little hair is under. So I have one little piece of hair left. I'm gonna spiral that under, and that helps it to stay, so that way you won't need bobby pins. So now with that, her hair is complete. Again, all we used was the Angellic Beauty Products oil. Let me show you how much we used. Can you see that? And I just did her whole head. So now she has 16 Bantu knots in her head. This is from a dry state. So what I did is I parted it into four big sections, two in the front, two in the back. With each of those four sections, I then made four sections out of each one of those sections. So I have four sections here. I put a nickel to a quarter size amount of the oil on my hand, worked it through from end to root, and thumb combed it as I went to stretch it and to make sure it was saturated with the oil. Then I twisted it and then Bantu knotted it. Now what I'm calling this is a Bantu beach wave, because Naptural85 did a tutorial on this style a while ago, and she called it beach waves, where you twist the hair first and then install the Bantu knots. So can you show them from the back? You have, she has.
Well, if I want to shave it close, so I want to rock locks that'll take a bit away from the soul that I got. Little girl with the pressing curl, age 8, I got a Jerry curl, 13 and I got a